Guys, here for Chaz Bitt on the outside stand up show, can we think about? And Sid on the trumpet solo. And Chris Storm on the drums. All right. And that's Adam Gilman on the bass. There he is. All right, everyone, say hello to Ken Ruth, who is coming to the drums right there. So anyone recognize the tune that that was based on? Girl from Ipanema. Excellent, excellent. And that's what we do here. We look to the source. We start with arrangements, and then we look back to see what song was that based on? What's the original song sound like? Who recorded it? Music history ties right in to adhering to the style, making sure that we play every style in a pure fashion. So we're going to continue now with some Duke Ellington. Here is Don't Get Around Much Anymore. Some of the most unusual but fantastic places. At a recent jazz conference, I was able to get this chart through the United States Air Force Jazz Ambassadors Band. And they have a website where they give free charts to band directors and to schools. Your tax dollars at work. It's fantastic. It's a wonderful, wonderful resource. It's amazing how good all of the service bands are. And I think you're going to agree when you listen to this beautiful original composition that Henry is going to be featured on. It's called Together Houses. Thank you. Ballad playing is by far the most difficult kind of playing because everything is so exposed. And then to be a featured soloist on a ballad is incredible. Henry, marvelous. And the band. Yeah. And by the way, Sebastian, come out. That was Sebastian on the bass. Come on out, Sebastian. Yeah. Think about it. That's Sebastian on the bass. Yeah. All right. And Sid on the trumpet solo. And Chris Storm on the drums. All right. And that's Adam Gilman on the bass. There he is. All right, everyone, say hello to Ken Ruth, who is coming to the drums right there. So anyone recognize the tune that was based on? Girl from Ipanema, excellent, excellent. And that's what we do here. We look to the source, we start with arrangements, and then we look back to see what song was that based on? What's the original song sound like? Who recorded it? Music history ties right in to adhering to the style, making sure that we play every style in a pure fashion. So we're going to continue now with some Duke Ellington. Here is Don't Get Around Much Anymore.
Thank you.
Thank you so much, Nick Hallenthal from the trumpet. Let's take a bow. Some charts at some of the most unusual but fantastic places. At a recent jazz conference, I was able to get this chart through the United States Air Force Jazz Ambassadors Band. And they have a website where they give free charts to band directors and to schools. Your tax dollars at work. It's fantastic. It's a wonderful, wonderful resource. It's amazing how good all of the service bands are, and I think you're going to agree when you listen to this beautiful original composition that Henry is going to be featured on. It's called Together Houses.
Thank you.
ballad playing is by far the most difficult kind of playing because everything is so exposed. And then to be a featured soloist on a ballad is incredible. Henry, marvelous. And the band. Yeah. And by the way, Sebastian, come out. That was Sebastian on the bass. Come on out, Sebastian. Yeah. Think about it. That's Sebastian on the bass. Yeah. All right. I can't believe this is the end of the set. It's unbelievable. It's months and months of work for a half-hour set, but that's what we put into it. And it's really funny because I know our advanced band is out there and they hear some of the tunes that we're playing and they played those tunes when they were in the intermediate band and so on and so forth. And that's what we've been doing here for 15 years. It's been really incredible. And we have a system in place by which we train our students at this level. And so many of them are freshmen. Raise your hand if you're a freshman. Whoa, that's a lot. Okay. Whoa, I'd like to hear that. It's pretty amazing. It really is. It's pretty amazing. And that's what we do here. And of course, we recognize a lot of the tunes from our dance book, which we've been compiling for over 10 years, where we play our gigs. And it's really very gratifying to see the next group come up and then move on to advance. So I'm very, very pleased with what's been going on here. I'm very proud to have been building this program for so long. Well, we're gonna finish with a very complex chart, and this goes beyond the general intermediate level. This is really quite an advanced chart, and we're going to do it for you. It's in your program. It's by a great writer named Fred Stride. It's called Something for Ernie, and we've got Shane on the bass and David McGinnis on the drums. And here we go. One, two, three. Was he attended? Come on, stand up there, lad. And his friend, David McGinnis. Stand up. Stand on bass. And now all his throwback friends, stand up. Come on, you guys. Wave to the crowd. Take a bow. Come on. That's 3 months to put that show together. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. All right, so we do our own staging here, so you can dim the lights for a little bit and just bear with us for just a couple of minutes. We're going to do a little set staging, and we're going to bring up our jazz combo. Henry, you got some more in you? You got a little combo set in you? Okay, great. We'll keep you here. All right, thank you so much, ladies and gentlemen. Talk amongst yourselves for a minute, and we're going to reset the stage. Thank you.
Thank you.
Is this working?
Oh, yes.
First of all, unbelievable or what? Unbelievable or what? So I've been telling this story for the past week and a half, and when I decided to tell the story again, I wanted a little bit of a way to get into the story. And something recently happened in the news that gave me the idea. And it gave me a little bit of a theme to think about. And the theme is, the bigger they are, the bigger the mistake. So listen, this is what happened recently. At a Major League Baseball game, the San Diego Padres, they invited a 100-person choir onto the baseball field to sing the national anthem. Did anyone hear about this story? It's unbelievable. So they get out there, and they're about to sing the national anthem. You can imagine what a moment that is for every one of those choir members on a baseball field, San Diego Padres, Major League game, about to sing the Star Spangled Banner. And as soon as they start singing, the canned music version of it comes blasting through the loudspeakers. And it was unbelievable. It was all over the news. They're getting sued, this, that, and the other. And I'm thinking to myself, who's at the dial there? Who are those people out on that field with the microphones? Oh, it must be time for me to play the national anthem. I think I'll press that button. I can't believe it. So it just goes to show that the bigger they are, the bigger the mistake. And a mistake like that happened to this group at the Reno Jazz Festival. Make a long story short, they played phenomenally. And unfortunately, there was a scoring error which put them way at the bottom. And of course, we went through the whole procedures, took about 2 weeks, and we finally revealed that they indeed win first place. I see Glenn Miller right in front of me, because I remember when I started storming up those steps going, okay, I gotta find out what's going on here. Glenn, it took 2 weeks for this to happen, okay? By the way, the big band was phenomenal, and they got 3 superiors and technically 6th place. Very competitive festival. They were fantastic. Give them a round of applause. So, anyway, apologies, but the reality of it was, yeah, they didn't get that moment, you know? But what about that choir? They didn't get their moment either, you know? But, you know, you pick yourself up, you start all over again, and the reality of it is, there's always another chance to have a moment. There really is. So, Ryan, congratulations, and your friends have a little something for you. Come on, all of you guys. Hold it up. Congratulations. Come on, get out there. Get out there. Here's a Susan Bill. How about you keep a secret? Come on. Come on, everyone. Get those pictures. I'm kidding. Ship it to my house. I got it Saturday. I've been sitting on this story for 3 days. Oh, what a number for my mind. There it is, ladies and gentlemen. Congratulations. Thank you for having a moment. Get the pictures. Enjoy an intermission, and you're going to hear an unbelievable big band, the Advanced Band, with our guest artist, the Jazz Choir. Thank you, everybody.
Energy and this one.
Pasadena. So I got to see her, and then I didn't know, but my dad's brother and his wife came as well, so I got to see them. So I said, you know, you should probably go see him if you want to see him, kind of thing. So they're going to go, I think, next month.
Up there, John? Bottom left corner.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
No, on that picture up there.
Oh, up there.
On the left, bottom left. What'd you think of the combo? The two musicians, huh? And one saxophone player is in the freshman.
That one that was in the other band, right? Yeah.
Unfortunately, that I think the drummer and the bass helped all the others.
Hi, Donna. I wanted to say hi.
Hey. I saw you come in, Sheila.
Kathleen.
To see Kathleen coming in.
She should be.
Yeah.
They had their big concert Friday.
He came so.
Were you here?
Yeah.
Thursday.
And she had a couple solos in that. It was good. I liked it. Thanks for the chance. It might be off as well. She's going to college next year, studying the music conservatory. It's in Sweden.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
It's a music conservatory. So, hi, Sean. So I'm excited for her. She's just thrilled. And I said, what are you excited about college? And I assume I'm going to study at home, but and she's like, I'm going to be with everybody who loves music as much as I am. That's what her thing is. I'm glad they're here. You won't get to hear the solo thing, but the group is very good. They make it fun. She has fun. She's the soprano, so if you hear a high note, that's her. That was fun. 42nd Street. That was a good one. Well, she was in the Dos Pueblos play. They had something called the Grand Duchy. And she had a big part. Yeah, it was so much fun. She had a really fun one.
You know Mike?
Sure. I get to know a lot of them. They work at the junior hall. So, yeah. I love it there, and it's like a little piece of Helena. Most everybody has a kid go through there. I think most every kid has braces, so they have to come and go. I get to know a lot of things. I have been. I've been doing it for 18 years. The kids have their own kids.
Yeah. You're looking good. You can laugh.
Yay, you like to hear that. You too.
Wow.
You always. It's that walk in. I started this new thing. I love it. It's my favorite thing. A dance class. Who knew I'd like dancing, but this is that's my new thing.
I don't mind dancing.
This is just all women, and it's all called world dance. I love it. My new thing. Nice talking to you.
Nice talking to you.
No, I'm just saying, take a smoke and go in.
What? No, no, no.
Mateo is standing up and taking it. Isaiah Garcia. Thank you so much. Gosh, it seems like yesterday we started this chart and we debuted the chart at the DP Jazz Festival with Tom Scott as the guest artist. It's an amazing year that we've had. So we're really, really fortunate, and we're fortunate to celebrate our music with you at the end of this concert season. We're going to continue. By the way, what you're listening to now is our Reno set. So this is a really fantastic set of music. That was called The Deciding Factor. It was written by Jack Cooper, a wonderful, wonderful writer. And we're going to move to another great writer and a good friend of ours from Cal State Long Beach, written by Jeff Jarvis. This is Bossa Nueva. Thank you.
Thank you.
son, Isabella. This is the set that we lived with for at least 6 months, and you know that it could grow tiresome, but at the same time it's like our set, and I feel like we're really sharing that set with you tonight. We're not just like, you know, oh, we played this 1,000 times, but it's like, hey, this is our set, check it out. So I really enjoy your set, guys. Thank you so much. And we're going to finish that set with a tune that has almost become like our theme song of the year, because it was the day that I brought the chart out, everyone instantly loved it. And why not? What's not to love about Dave Brubeck? I mean, it's Dave Brubeck. It's the best. So this is a great chart by Chris Berg, and a little homage to the original recording, as some of you might hear if you listen to the original. This is such a great chart. This is Blue Rondeau on a Turf.
Thank you.
Conservatory-like. So he said, yeah, I have this great arrangement by the New York Voices, fantastic vocal group, kind of in the Manhattan Transfer kind of style. I had this fantastic arrangement of jazz choir with big band, already scored, but I never had the voices really to pull it off. But she did such a wonderful job with her group this year. I said, why don't we try this? So we debuted Friday night. Has it been Friday night? Gosh, what day is it? We debuted Friday night at the choir concert, and it was really fun and really great. So we're gonna do that, plus one more, plus one more, plus one more, and then go on. Anyway, so this is great. This is the New York Voices arrangement of the great classic, I Could Write a Book. I forgot to mention, because he's been playing actually all night, that's Julian Littlehale on bass. Give it up for Julian. Thank you for having me on.
Hey, let's give it up for Mr. Rose.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Let's hear it for them. We'll call them DP voices, right?
Oh, yeah.
Intricate, sophisticated chart that they did beautifully. Thank you guys so much. Well, we're going to do something that's completely different. We're going to have some fun. You guys are going to clap along if you want to dance in the aisles, you can. But we are now going to boogie down. I just realized I did not acknowledge my other bass player. I think I have about 8 bass players, but say hello to Jeremiah McElwee. I mean, I just even though I'm keeping time, that's great. Thank you. because we have one more, and we often end with this as a finale. By the way, let me say something, okay? I've been performing and being a professional musician for over 40 years, and just to see my students have that zest and that enthusiasm for performance along with the precision is just so gratifying. I want to thank you guys for just a fantastic night of music. A little backstory, I visited my mother this weekend. This is my niece's 25th birthday. They all know that because she calls me at 4 o'clock every day in the afternoon. Hey, when your mom is 91 and you get a phone call every day, that's a good thing. Anyway, my mom used to tell me that I played hooky from high school to go and hear the big bands at Radio City Music Hall because they had a pit that would rise, and then she would hear Gene Krupa with the Benny Goodman Orchestra, and it would rise, and as soon as it got to the top, it was the most exhilarating feeling ever. So that's kind of why I've been playing Sing 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 forever as my finale, and here we go.
Kyle Doherty. One.
Thank you.
Good night, everybody. We'll see you at the awards banquet on Thursday. Good night.